Hey guys, back with another cue review. This time it's a $300 cue from JFlowers. $300, that also includes a carbon fiber shaft actually. The tip on this cue is a 12.2mm Mori multi-layered tip. It's a medium tip and it's a good tip. It may not come as a surprise, but it's Canadian maple that is being used for the butt. Overall, in my humble opinion, the JF1001F is a well-balanced cue. You can find more details and even order it at JFlowersCues.com. If you like my videos, please don't forget to subscribe. And you can also consider putting on that notification bell. This way you'll get alerts the next time we post our next video. And guys, also, when we hit the 1,000 subscribers, I'm going to give away a free cue. And don't worry, shipping is included. So let me give you a little background on JFlowers. They're certainly not a new kid on the block. They've been around since 2004. They've got 200 employees at their factory, and they're pretty known for their handmade genuine leather cue cases. The price range for the JFlowers cues is from $300 all the way up to $3,000. Since I got so many great feedbacks on the previous tip of the week, I'm gonna continue doing it. This time I'm gonna take a look at two-way shots. So this is not an uncommon situation. You're tempted to go for the bank, but the angle isn't really there. That means you need to put some right spin on it, and that will leave the cue ball in an unfavorable position afterwards. So depending whether or not this is the final of the US Open or if you're just playing for lunch money with a friend, I would definitely consider hiding behind a 9 ball. The safe zone behind a 9 is pretty big. And obviously, since this is a two-way shot, once in a while you will make the cross bank, but you are trying to miss it on purpose. You just gotta make sure that you have the correct speed so it will reach the third rail and not leaving your opponent an easy jump shot. I think that looking for two-way shots in high-pressure situation is a much overlooked area. It's a winning strategy in my opinion. Now let's move over to the actual cue that we're reviewing today. The model name is the JF1001F. And it's between 19 and 19 and a half ounces. The carbon fiber shaft plays great. The Mori tip is good. And I think that this is an awesome beginner cue. Or if it's your first time considering buying a carbon fiber shaft, and you're not prepared to spend $400 to $600 on more well-known brands. Obviously, this is not an inlay cue, it's a decal cue, and I don't know the quality of the components they are using in the shafts. Having said that, I've tried several JFlowers cues and other products, and I feel that they are paying attention to the quality. JFlowers is a brand not known in the US, and right now they're really trying hard to penetrate the American market. So their prices are, well, I can say they're priced to sell. So I think that in a year, perhaps this kind of cue would be perhaps $500. So if you're considering one, yeah, perhaps you should pull the trigger right now. As you may or may not know, I've tested a bunch of carbon fiber shafts. Some of them actually make some funny noises when you hit the cue ball. So let's see if this is the case with this carbon fiber shaft from JFlowers. Nope, nothing funny going on there. I don't know the silencer foam they're using, but I think that they've paid attention to the sound, because the sound is, us pool players, we're prone to a lot of different things, and sound being one of them. Alright, so that's a nice segue over to another area we are prone to as pool players, and that's deflection. So let me just go ahead and debunk a myth straight away. Carbon fiber shafts does not have lower deflection than low deflection wooden shafts. They're about the same. And the differences between each carbon fiber shaft is minute. And just for the hell of it, I took out three different carbon fiber shafts. JFlowers, Q-Tech, and Jacobi. Let's take a look. I want you to notice in the top right corner, I'm highlighting an area. So this scene took me 1 minute to shoot, and I hit pretty much the same spot on the rail every single time. So I just did this to prove that there's not a whole lot of difference in the deflection on either of these shafts. I'm sure there are more scientific ways of proving my point, but well, there you go. Alright, let's move over to some draw shots and see what this bad boy can do. I think that one of the advantages of a carbon fiber shaft is that it will give you consistent results over time. Besides being way easier to scratch and get dings, a wooden shaft can also behave different depending on the environment that you bring it into. So if you are looking for consistent results, a carbon fiber shaft is the way to go. I would recommend using a glove, but you know, that's my personal preference. Coming up is a bonus tip for the ones of you who are still around. You don't really want to be in this situation, but here we are, so you're dead straight on the 8 ball. By elevating your cue and putting maximum left spin on it, you actually change the tangent line. The cue ball will move a little to the right before it starts moving down towards the 9 ball. And hey, if you get really unlucky and get corner hooked, you just gotta pull out one of those efferent race shots. So I tried to figure out how to conclude my review on this particular cue. So I hope I've been clear that there will be differences in quality when you're comparing this shaft to, you know, a $600 shaft. Let there be no doubt about it. However, I think that this cue, this shaft, is an awesome alternative for beginners. Not everybody can afford, or perhaps it's too soon to splash out, you know, thousands of dollars on the cue and the shaft and everything. So I think that this is a great alternative for beginners, or if you're just interested in seeing if you like carbon fiber shafts. Sure, $300, it's not a huge leap of faith to try it out. And also, although it's a decal cue, it looks pretty damn good. I have to be honest, you can fool a lot of your friends in the pool hall bringing this out. So, thanks for watching, and please consider subscribing.